Okay, like I said before, what we're going to do now is extract data from our API, okay, this API here, and set everything up so we can start putting everything together in the back end, if you will, before we put all of that in our application, right, where users can actually see. Okay, time for some instant gratification here, or maybe not so instant, but some sort of gratification for us to be able to see, okay, we are indeed connecting and all is good. Again, if you are just now joining us, please make sure to add your API key or API ID, in this case, actually app ID, as they call it. Doesn't matter what you call it, as long as we put the actual ID that we get from the API. Important, otherwise, we can have issues, folks, and we don't want that. I don't think that's going to be helpful. Okay, we understand how to use the future types to get stuff from an API. So what I'm going to do at the bottom here, so if you click here, you notice this is indeed inside of the class, right? Hover over. It is inside of a climatic state class here. Inside, I'm going to go ahead and create a method called future. And I'm going to pass here a map type. Now, you notice the moment you do that, this is not being recognized. Well, the reason why, if you hover over and click, it says we need to import the async dart. So click that, and voila. Once that is happening, you notice at the top, now we have dart async. We could have done ourselves, but hey, there we go. Okay? Speaking of instant gratification, I'm going to call this getWeather. I'm going to pass a few things here. First one is app ID. Oh, remember that? Next going to be a string called its city. I'm going to make this async because we need that to make sure that we are able to get the stuff and wait and do all the things that we need to do. So now, of course, we have to do some things here in order for this to work. The first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to create a string type. I'm going to call this API URL. This is the URL that we talked about before, right? Where we are going to retrieve all of this data. In fact, I'm going to just go ahead and copy this and change accordingly. All right, so I'm going to make this a string. I'm going to pass all of this stuff, but I'm going to remove a few things. Like this thing, I'm going to remove. I'm going to remove what else? So I've got that and this San Diego thing. So I'm going to, for a question here or query, I'm going to just pass the city. I'll say like city like that, which is being passed in. And then for the app ID, I'm going to go ahead and say util. I can't access it because even though I was able to import it, I'm going to say as util. Right, so a handle there. So now if I say util, I want to say dot app ID. Whoops. Perhaps I have to go like this. You know. There we go. App ID. Just like that. Finalize it like this. So what this is doing is that now we are constructing our API URL, which means now when we call this, we're gonna pass the app ID, which is exactly what we need. Finish that there. And we're gonna pass the city for the query. Remember, if you go here, look at this. This is where we pass the query. What is it, what city that we want to get the information from? So if I say Rio, those of you who are in Rio de Janeiro, you can see we got all that information. So if you, whatever you change here, it's going to get the information from that city. I think I want this to be imperial. So that it's in Fahrenheit, because I live in the United States, even though I still don't quite understand why Fahrenheit. Why not just use the metric system? I always tell my wife, who's also an American, and but you know what? That's what we get. We live in this awesome place, so that's totally fine. Metric system is much better. Okay, so because it's the future, we have to return a future type. So we've done this before. The next thing we need to do is to have an HTTP response. So then we can pass the API URL so we can actually get the JSON. Okay, so I'm going to say HTTP dot, and I'm going to have issues because it doesn't know what HTTP is because we have to actually get it. I'm going to say dot response. So maybe that's going to help. Still nothing. Click. Okay. I think we have to do this by hand. So I'm going to go up top here. say import, say HTTP, there we go. And let's say as HTTP. So we have that handle. The moment you do that, there we go, response. I'm gonna make this a response, okay? And this response, we're gonna say wait to make sure that whatever we're doing, it stops before we get anything. Then I'm gonna say http.get. I'm gonna pass our API URL, or, right? Of course, as this comes in, API URL is just gonna go ahead and get a response type. We need to decode it, right? So I'm gonna say return. I'm gonna say JSON. And of course, this JSON, return. JSON is nothing to this because we don't have it. We have to import the Dart convert library. So click that. Look at the top, we have Dart convert. Very cool. So we have that. What are we gonna do? Say JSON, invoke the decoder, and we're gonna pass our response. But not just our response, we're gonna pass the body of our response like that. So now, when we call getWeather, remember this is a future type, asynchronous stuff happening in the background, we're gonna return then a JSON, decoded JSON object, which is gonna be a type map, which we can use to then loop through and get all this information. So this, whatever is being returned, it's essentially going to be all of this in a map format. Okay, now notice if I try to say get, nothing really happens. The reason why, if you remember correctly, any async method or function has to be called inside of an async function or method. So in order for us to see this working, I can come here and say, for instance, void show stuff, just an example here, make sure it's an async as such. And then I can say get, look at that, get weather. I can pass the API ID, in this case, in some utils, API ID. And for the CD, I can actually say API or util dot default CD, which we know it's gonna be Spokane, right? If you go back, there we go. You see the easiness, how easy this is now? Now, once I get this, remember, this is gonna be a map. So I have to go and say map data is equal. And I'm gonna have an issue here because again, I'm inside of async. So I have to say await like that. Okay, so now if I go ahead and say print, say data, I have to say to string just for us to see all of that as a string so we don't feel neglected. Let's go ahead and call this show stuff somewhere, maybe here. Let's get rid of this. Show stuff like that. So that means whenever we tap on our sandwich button, we should be able to see something, hopefully. Let's run this. Okay, let's go ahead and run. All right, sometimes, like, you know, we're still in beta, things just happen like this and everything just looks very strange, even though our application has changed a lot. What I usually do, again, I just go ahead here and comment something out and save and hit hot reload like that. And then forces me to restart and then look at that. Let me change this back. So little tricks you learn. Save. And probably have to do a little hot reload again. There we go. Okay, we should be good again. Okay. All right, so let's keep our eyes here. If I click here, and voila. Very cool. So we know now we're able to get the information, the weather information. It's looking really good. Look at this. All of this as a string type, we're able to get it. Very cool. Let's see. It says here US. That's the country. Indeed. All of this great information. Very good. So it's working. That means now our future here, this future method or function that we are passing in the app ID and the CD It's going into the interwebs HTTP request, and we're passing it all here, the CD that we passed, and then the app ID, and gets the response, and all that stuff happens. And then here we created at the top the show stuff where we are converting, getting the map, and call the get weather and pass the actual ID and our default CD, and we're gonna print data to string. So we can see here it's showing, which is awesome. Okay, let's see if this is true. If it's, this should be Spokane, temp is 52. Is that true? Let's put here Spokane. This is in metric. I want Imperial. And it is 52.6. Yes, 52.16, I should say. 52.16. Great. If you were able to get this to this point, congratulations. This is great news. Of course, this is again was our instant gratification that we love so much. So that way we are assured that things are set up correctly and your API IDs and all that stuff is great. Cool, great. So in the next video, obviously what we're going to be doing is to get to the point where we can start calling or getting this information and put it here, right? The actual temp. Perfect. I'll see you in the next video.